Today on Good Morning Maine, Maine's Catholic Diocese is facing new lawsuits from people who say they have been abused by clergy.
Plus details on a special event that will remember those who have died from overdoses and what needs to be done to help those who are struggling.
And a local college is offering a special plan to help the state cope with a shortage of nurses. Good morning and welcome to Good Morning Maine. I'm Emma Smith.
And I'm Craig Colson. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. We'll have all the day's news coming up. But first, a check of the forecast, and it looks like kind of like not a big stormy day or anything, but we will have a few scattered showers today. No big deal.
Kind of dark out right now, though. There's a big blue cloud over Bangor.
Yeah, kind of ominous looking.
I'm feeling it, too. I feel like a big blue cloud
Do
today.
You?
Yeah. Yeah, I'll try not to. Like,
it's Tuesday too.
Be the shadow on your day, though.
It's okay. I'll be the bright and sunny to your cloud.
Sounds good.
Yeah,
you usually are.
I'll try.
Here's Devin Biggs back from his vacation for our full weather forecast.
Alrighty, thank you very much. Happy Tuesday, your first weather forecast brought to you by Marilyn Monroe Spas. Sign up for your VIP spa membership today and access exclusive members-only services and benefits. It's the perfect gift for the summer. All right, let's get things rolling after this morning. Some areas of dense fog developing out there. We're noticing a little bit of that in your parts of Caribou this morning, and parts of Washington County seeing some of that as well. Not seeing too much else across the viewing area, at least at this point. We'll be watching for maybe some fog again throughout the morning period today, but for now that we're watching some clouds that are developing out there, we'll be watching for maybe a few showers throughout the afternoon period as well before the sunshine comes out for a little bit. And then later on tonight, areas of dense fog will be developing again. So here's that chance of rain right here, tracking from the southwest to the north and east. So by about late morning to early afternoon, we'll be watching for the rain to move in. Then by about mid to late afternoon, we'll watch for the clouds to break up to reveal some sunshine before it sets later on this evening. Futurecast showing that nicely as we start to see a little bit of sunshine during the afternoon period. And then areas of dense fog and clouds start to move in overnight tonight. So otherwise, the wind's not a huge deal. They will remain rather calm today, mainly at around 5 miles per hour or less. So we're looking pretty good today and also in the parts of tomorrow. So for today, though, upper 70s, scattered showers and becoming partly cloudy with the wind overall looking nice and calm. Later on tonight, upper 50s, mostly cloudy areas of dense fog out there with the wind overall looking nice and calm. Our only forecast for the rest of the morning and afternoon period, a cloudy sky, chances for showers, temperatures in the 70s. Your full 5 day forecast is coming up.
All right, thank you, Devin. Well, officials attempted to hold an arraignment Monday for the man accused of stabbing a Bangor emergency medical worker. That proceeding happened Monday afternoon. Justin Hill of Portland was at the Penobscot Judicial Center for what would have been his initial court appearance and arraignment. But due to his inability to cooperate, his arraignment has been postponed until Wednesday of this week.
Hello, I'm Justin Hill. I have a machine device.
Well, the attorney representing Hill in court says he has not been able to communicate to Hill the charge that he's facing. According to Bangor police, Hill is facing a charge of aggravated assault after he allegedly stabbed an on-duty EMT worker outside the Circle K on Odlin Road in Bangor early Sunday morning. The victim was taken to a local hospital for cuts to his hand and head. He does not know Hill or understand why he would attack him. During the court appearance, a representative of the state requested a Title 15 examination, which would have him mentally evaluated.
Okay, so this will be revisited on Wednesday afternoon on the in-custody list. We have notes in the file here that we will attempt to get through an initial appearance and a reading of the charges, and that the state has, at least preliminarily, raised its intent to request a Title 15 examination.
Hill will be held without bail until at least Wednesday.
Another person is facing charges following a crash in Castine that killed four Maine Maritime Academy students. Noel Tavares of Massachusetts was indicted Friday on charges including four counts of manslaughter, criminal OUI, and other charges. According to the Bangor Daily, the investigation since the December crash revealed additional evidence that Tavares aided in the unlawful conduct that led to the deadly crash. Tavares was one of three survivors. Joshua Concalves Redding of New York was the driver, and he's also facing numerous charges, including manslaughter, criminal speeding, and aggravated OUI. One survivor says he was driving over 100 miles per hour when he lost control and hit a tree.
Well, six new civil lawsuits have been filed against the Roman Catholic Bishop of Portland for alleged sexual abuse by several clergy members, bringing the total number of cases to 30. Our Matthew Jaroncic has the story.
Robert Rosignol, originally from Washington County, and Glenn Witham of Augusta are two of the most recent survivors speaking out about the alleged sexual abuse they experienced under the Roman Catholic Bishop of Portland when they were younger. They're asking those who've had similar experiences to share their story.
The Catholic Church needs to be reprimanded. As far as I'm concerned, they're a cult.
The most recent lawsuit brings the total number of cases against the Roman Catholic Bishop of Portland to 30. But Berman Simmons attorney Timothy Kenlin says it doesn't stop there.
These represent only a fraction of the cases that we have and the cases that we intend to bring forward in the coming months. We represent around 100 or more survivors of child and sexual abuse at the hands of members of the Catholic Church at all levels.
The lawsuits claim the alleged abuse occurred at different locations from clergy statewide as early as 1954, spanning almost three decades, with each complainant explaining in disturbing detail what they say unfolded. One lawsuit claims the organization allegedly knew what was going on but failed to do anything. At one point, a nun allegedly told a plaintiff in French, quote, "We must never tell anyone this."
It just needs to change. It just needs to change. I will not set foot in a Catholic church ever again in my life.
We reached out to the Roman Catholic Bishop of Portland regarding a response, but did not hear back. Matthew Jaroncic, ABC 7 and Fox 22 News.
A man was seriously injured Sunday night while walking along a roadway in Medway. The East Millinocket Police Department says emergency crews were called to Route 157 just before 10 o'clock Sunday night. They say a 40-year-old man from Bradford had been walking along the road between the Gateway Inn and the Circle K when he was struck by a passing vehicle. Officials say the man suffered serious injuries and was transported to the Millinocket Hospital before being transferred to Northern Light Eastern Maine Medical Center. The early investigation indicates the driver of a Hyundai SUV couldn't avoid the pedestrian because he was walking in the roadway. There's no word on his condition.
Well, a vehicle collision shut down a section of I-95 for about an hour on Sunday, according to the Department of Public Safety, Public Information Officer Shannon Moss. Shortly after 2 p.m. Sunday afternoon, Maine troopers responded to a two-vehicle crash at mile marker 79 northbound on I-95 in Lewiston. When troopers arrived, they found two Subarus involved in the accident, one of which was fully engulfed in flames and partially blocking the travel lane, causing the entire northbound side to be shut down. Police say the vehicle that caught fire had been traveling in the passing lane when the driver lost control and struck the second vehicle. The second vehicle suffered minor damage and was able to pull over. The first vehicle then struck the median concrete barrier before stopping in the breakdown and travel lanes. One driver not injured, the other sustained only minor injuries. That crash also remains under investigation.
Maine is close to becoming one of the few states in the country to provide a retirement savings program to workers who don't have access to one through their jobs. The Maine Retirement Savings Program is designed to provide a way for Maine residents to contribute to a Roth individual in retirement account directly from their paychecks. The workers would retain the account from job to job until they retire. Democratic Senator Eloise Vitelli of Arosic says a pilot version of the program is slated to start this fall. Vitelli says the full program is expected to be phased in through January of 2026.
Well, over the weekend, a powerful storm system moved across the state, resulting in multiple lightning strikes. Officials say two individuals were sitting in the kitchen at their home in Newburgh when a current went through the house, shocking both individuals. Both received a shock but were not hurt. And a Carmel man was also struck by lightning while standing in his garage. There was no damage to the structure, and paramedics say he was fully responsive on the scene and did not seek further medical treatment.
Most fatal lightning strikes can be avoided with simple precautions like checking the forecast and staying inside or going indoors when you hear thunder. People sometimes think, oh, it'll never happen to me, but it's better to err on the side of caution and to play it safe.
Well, the Maine Emergency Management Agency says Mainers should follow these helpful safety tips when a lightning storm strikes. You can see them on your screen there. The agency says to remember there is really no safe place outside during a thunderstorm. More information can be found on our website at foxbangor.com. Don't go outside.
Away from windows and doors. Don't be in water. Don't be touching any metal surfaces.
Yeah.
It's a lot of stuff.
I thought we'd have more TVs blowing up. You know, according to my childhood, we always had to run around and unplug things and unplug the TV. That's something that they always told us growing up when a lightning storm's coming through the area. But darn it, I haven't seen a TV blow up yet.
TVs blowing up.
I'm waiting for it. But
Yeah. Maybe that would be a good thing.
I don't even plug them in, unplug them anymore.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
No, I don't want my TV to blow up.
No, I don't. Really. I don't want it either. Okay, the time now is 6:10. Coming up next on Good Morning Maine, a local college is offering training for people in remote locations to help fill the state's nursing shortage. We'll have the details.
But first, another check of that weather forecast. Today, scattered showers on the way with a high near 77 degrees. Mostly cloudy overnight with lows dropping down to the upper 50s. Tomorrow, a mostly cloudy day on the way. It will be drier, though, with a high near 74.
Renovating or building new, you'll find a wide selection of high-performing, energy-efficient, and beautiful windows and doors at Hammond Lumber Company. Your Hammond sales representative will walk you through the showroom displays and help you choose options to create a personalized custom look. Free in-home measurement is available, and Hammond can deliver your order from any of their locations across Maine and New Hampshire. Bring your vision and enjoy better light and added security and energy savings with quality windows and doors from Hammond Lumber Company.
The Lumineers. Glorious. 2023 Tour. August 16th, Maine Savings Amphitheater, Bangor, Maine. With special guest, James Bay. On sale now. Buy tickets at Ticketmaster.com. The Lumineers. Check out their latest album, Brightside, available everywhere.
Hello, Eastern Maine. Watch You Bet Your Life weekdays at 10 a.m. here on ABC 7.
This is the most exciting part of the day.
I'm just going to bet it all.
Yeah, baby.
You never know what's going to happen on Jeopardy.
This is high-level competition.
Get ready for a thrill ride.
This is Jeopardy.
Ooh, that's fun.
Anything can happen here.
This week at 7:30, only on ABC 7.
International Overdose Awareness Day is August 31st. Healthy Acadia's program, Inspire Recovery Center, will be holding an event at Knowlton Park to remember the lives cut short and to recognize the ones that are just beginning again. Doug Banks has the story.
People give us dirty looks. I see it all the time out here in the parking lot, you know. We're not bad people. We're just good people trying to get well.
Recognizing those people who go unseen is the message Inspire Recovery Center is sending out ahead of International Overdose Awareness Day on August 31st. Scheduled to be held at Knowlton Park from 6:30 p.m. to 8 p.m., the event will include a memory board, a candlelight vigil, and the number 723 will be represented through black balloons and butterflies. According to Inspire Recovery Center, 723 Mainers died from overdoses in 2022.
These are members of our community. Like, I work with people on a regular basis who are in recovery, who are in active use, and then I work with people who are in our community who are neither of those things. And none of them are better than anybody else.
One of the many things the men and women from Inspire Recovery Center want this day to be is a step towards the end of the stigma against recovery.
Well, hopefully people will come by, whether they've lost somebody or not, and just to see what it's all about. You know, they see it from the outside, but they don't know what goes on inside. And so, you know, maybe it'll open up some eyes.
Someone who loses their life to overdose, it impacts the community in some way. Somebody's mother, brother, sister, cousin, friend, daughter, grandparent, whatever, that person is something to somebody. Even if they've burned every bridge behind them and every bridge in front of them, that person is still somebody to somebody.
In Ellsworth, Doug Banks, ABC 7 and Fox 22 News.
Meanwhile, nursing shortages are causing challenges across the country, and that includes here in Maine. Our Grace Blanchard spoke with a local college and hospital about their education-related efforts to address this growing crisis.
Hospitals continue to experience staffing shortages. They are looking towards educational initiatives to help resolve this widespread issue.
We've actually had a partnership with Mayo Regional Hospital for several years now.
Eastern Maine Community College in Bangor has been partnering with Northern Light Mayo Hospital in Dover Foxcroft to create a distance learning option for their nursing program.
We find that with this type of program, when the students are able to get their education in their hometowns or near their hometowns, they're more apt to stay there and work there.
The president of EMCC says the goal is to reach students in rural parts of the state.
Programs are really vital to these rural hospitals that are desperate for registered nurses.
And the program is meant to combat the growing nursing shortages seen all across the country.
Almost all hospitals nationwide have a nursing shortage right now.
The program allows students in rural parts of Maine to get all their requirements on site at a hospital as opposed to traveling to Bangor.
It was started so that we can keep graduates or keep nurses in their own home community so that they don't have to travel far away to find a job.
An informational session for the program will be held at Mayo Hospital on August 24th. More information can be found on our website at foxbangor.com. In Bangor, Grace Blanchard, ABC 7 and Fox 22 News.
It's nice they're doing that. There's, the problem is just going to get bigger because we have such an older population here in Maine. The need for nurses is not going away.
Yeah, exactly. I couldn't have said it better myself. Yeah. The time now is 6:17 after the break. A mobile home park in Wiscasset has been out of water for days now.
Plus, all the latest on the fourth indictment Donald Trump is now facing in Georgia. Those stories and more as Good Morning Maine continues.
Living in Maine means long, cold winters and hot, humid summers. Whatever the weather, Bangor Heat Pumps is your solution. Open 24/7, Bangor Heat Pumps takes care of you, at home or at work. We operate statewide and service all brands and models. Understanding moving can be stressful, we will help move any units you may have. We offer a veterans discount in our home with a Capeless Hero discount. Visit us online at bangorheatpumpsllc.com or call or text us at 307-7746. Bangor Heat Pumps.
You know what today is? It's Tuesday. But no matter what day of the week, Lowry & Associates is your go-to law firm. If you've been hurt, call us right now.
If you're hurt in an accident, what do you do? Call 222-2222.
Situated in Jonesboro on the coast of Maine lies Barren View Golf Course, a true links course that's a treat for golfers of all skill levels. We feature a driving range, putting green, practice sand trap, pro shop, and snack bar. Open 7 days a week. Please call ahead for a tee time.
Will there be water today or not? That's what some residents in Wiscasset have been asking themselves for months. And as Mal Meyer explains, those residents are still asking for help.
This morning there was none.
Erica Jo Hanks likes to keep track.
I document what I see.
Jotting down when something changes at the Whippoorwill Hill Mobile Home Park.
There was water last night. I did one load of laundry and some dishes and then got up this morning, thinking I'd shower, and there was nothing, not even any pressure.
In late February and early March, the site's property manager and its lawyer detailed a series of problems with the wells and water system to town and state officials. To help, bulk water was being brought in then and is now. Residents say it's not enough.
You don't know if you have water in the morning, if you're going to have water in the morning when you get up.
The attorney representing the management company sent an email to us. In addition to providing water bottles and jugs, they've added an additional bulk water delivery daily. They're working to drill a new supply well, but that company says a contract is still in the works. And when the tap, toilet, or shower does work, occasionally it looks like this.
And that's light compared to what it's been like.
Would you drink black water? And it's not just for a couple of hours.
Harmon says that water delivery can cause a fine gray sediment to be stirred up, and the water tank was recently cleaned. He claims they haven't received any complaints since that happened, and that it could be a problem with the line leading to a unit.
I'm fed up. Somebody needs to do something about it.
We contacted the Manufactured Housing Board about the situation. In response, a state official says they can't provide any information specifically in response, as complaints and investigations of the board are confidential during the pendency of an investigation.
I can't imagine. It's gone on too long.
Terrible.
Well, our media partners at WGME heard from the Maine CDC after this report. They say the park has until next Friday to get a new well installed. The agency has also reached out to the park owner to make sure they know that they must commit the resources to resolve this situation and meet appropriate deadlines.
Boy, just a horrible situation for them. Hopefully they get some relief soon.
Yeah, that's scary. Yeah. All right, the time now is 6:21.
Let's get a full look at our weather forecast.
All righty, happy Tuesday. Your full weather forecast brought to you by Marilyn Monroe Spas. Sign up for your VIP spa membership today and access exclusive members-only services and benefits. It's a perfect gift for the summer. Already, some areas have been fog developing out this morning, mainly near across parts of the Caribou area, near parts of Washington County as well. Everyone else looking okay for the time being. Maybe some patchy fog possible in a few spots this morning. For now, we're just watching clouds that are developing out there, tracking from the west, going toward the east. We're watching more rain as off for the west as well. This will be heading in our direction throughout the late morning into the early afternoon period as well. Then by around mid to late afternoon, we'll be watching for the clouds to break up just a bit to reveal some sunshine, courtesy of this area low pressure right about in here. High pressure to the north will also be our friend as it will help to push some of the clouds away later on. But for now, though, future cast moving forward showing clouds today with a few showers possible during the late morning to early afternoon. Then by around mid to late afternoon in the parts of the evening, the clouds break up. But notice what happens. The clouds move back in. Areas of dense fog also possible, and some that could linger in parts of Wednesday morning as well. We'll hold on to the clouds for your Wednesday. Slight chance for a shower or so. Then by around late in the day on Wednesday, the clouds will break up to reveal some sunshine before it begins to set. And then Wednesday night, more areas of dense fog will look to develop. So moving forward, though, today and tomorrow, nothing meaningful in the form of rain, maybe a tenth of an inch or less between now and early Thursday morning before we're all finished up. Later into the week, though, as we head towards Friday or so, we're going to be watching for more rain. It will be on the way. Maybe some locally higher amounts in your parts of Washington County. It will be very scattered in nature. So by around Friday or so, more rain will be on the way. Our average high temperature is 80 degrees. Upper 70s is what we'll do for us today. Middle 70s Wednesday. Back in the upper 70s for your Thursday. Middle 70s Friday into Saturday. Upper 70s again for your Sunday. And upper 70s again as we head towards your Monday. So as we talk about the dew points, so they will remain in the 60s over the next few days between today and also in the parts of Thursday. By Friday, though, here we go. Middle 60s on the way before we catch a little bit of a break. So for today, those scattered showers, temperatures in the upper 70s and becoming partly cloudy with the wind overall looking nice and calm. Upper 50s for tonight, mostly cloudy areas of dense fog on the way with the wind overall looking nice and calm. And for tomorrow, middle 70s on the way, mostly cloudy with a slight chance for a shower. Southeast wind at about 5 miles per hour. Marilyn Monroe Spa's extended forecast for mostly cloudy for your Thursday, highs in the upper 70s, middle 70s Friday with a chance for storms, and we're dry on Saturday, partly cloudy, highs in the mid-70s.
I got rear-ended at a stoplight and needed surgery, and the insurance company tried to give me this tiny little check.
This tiny little check won't even cover my car repairs.
After a car accident, don't take a tiny check from the insurance company. Call the twos.
I said no way to this tiny check. I called the twos, and Lowry & Associates got me $300,000.
I'm Jim with Lowry & Associates. Call the twos. We win for you.
If you're hurt in an accident, what do you do? Call 222-2222.
Scootic & Bloom, a full-service, custom-designed florist, Main Street in Winter Harbor.
We can deliver one-of-a-kind, full-color flower arrangements
by custom floral designer me, Pam.
Delivering to Ellsworth and surrounding areas for any occasion.
Please visit scooticandbloom.com or call 844-SCOOTIC.
Wow. Like the kids, the bills are getting bigger every month. I know. From childcare to electric, I don't know how we're gonna do it. We need to cut. Let's pay this one next month.
Not sure we can. We already cut everything. And now electricity prices are going up.
What are we gonna do? We need help.
I heard that the PUC's website has information about financial assistance and conservation programs.
We've never asked for help before.
I know.
But this year, things are different.
ABC 7, Fox 22, Healing Hands Massage, and Mainly Eyes want to send you to see Train live in concert with special guest Better Than Ezra Friday, August 18th at the Main Savings Amphitheater in Bangor. Sign up to win tickets by registering at Healing Hands Massage in Hamden, providing professional massage services tailored specifically for our clients. And Mainly Eyes in the Bangor Mall, the number one choice for your eye care and eyewear. Win tickets to see Train August 18th on the Bangor waterfront.
Wednesday.
When you say you're going to get married on Good Morning America,
I'm saying yes to marriage.
You better set a date.
You're invited to one joyous bachelorette party. Celebrate Robin and her fiance Amber right before they say I do. Only on GMA.
You're watching ABC 7 Bangor.
Welcome back, everyone. Overnight, Donald Trump was hit with his fourth indictment in just about as many months. A grand jury in Georgia issuing a nearly 100-page indictment accusing the former president and 18 others of a sweeping criminal conspiracy to overturn the 2020 election in the state. ABC's M. Nguyen has more from Atlanta.
Overnight in Georgia, Donald Trump hit with the fourth set of criminal charges implicating the former president as the head of a sweeping conspiracy to overturn the 2020 election results in the state. Trump and 18 others, including lawyers Rudy Giuliani and John Eastman, facing a 41-count indictment, all charged under Georgia's Racketeering Act, often used to prosecute organized crime.
I make decisions in this office based on the facts and the law. The law is completely nonpartisan.
Willis's probe, sparked in part by that phone call from Trump to Georgia's Secretary of State, where the former president appeared to pressure the top official to find the votes needed to win. Trump and his former chief of staff, Mark Meadows, both charged with solicitation of violation of oath by a public officer in relation to that call. These new charges, which also include violating the RICO Act, engaging in a conspiracy to replace public officials with fake electors, and plotting to tamper with voting machines, add to Trump's legal woes in the midst of his race for the White House.
Those are the kinds of allegations that are tougher to defend against.
The Republican frontrunner's campaign slamming the indictment as bogus, saying the legal double standards set against President Trump must end. And on Capitol Hill, top Democratic leaders issuing a statement saying this indictment portrays a repeated pattern of criminal activity, adding praise to Willis, saying no one is above the law. But House Speaker Kevin McCarthy and other top Republicans are defending Trump, accusing Willis of politicizing persecution, saying she's following Biden's lead by attacking President Trump.
District Attorney Willis has given all defendants, including Trump, until Friday, August 25th, to turn themselves in. She says she wants to hold the trial within the next 6 months. M. Nguyen, ABC News, Atlanta.
The Biden administration is calling on the U.S. Supreme Court to hear cases on some states' social media laws. The administration is urging the high court to take up a pair of cases that involve laws passed by Texas and Florida. The laws restrict how social media companies moderate posts on their platform. The Biden administration argues the laws violate the First Amendment.
Well, now to Maui, where police will start releasing the names of those killed by the Lahaina wildfire today, if their families have already been notified. Overnight, the death toll was at least 99 people, and Hawaii's governor says that number is all but certain to keep climbing. ABC's Morgan Norwood has the latest.
This morning, a grim message from Hawaii's governor as the death toll from the deadliest wildfire in more than a century continues to grow.
It's going to be emotionally catastrophic.
I understand that people want numbers. It's not a numbers game. It's not just ash on your clothing when you take it off. It's our loved ones.
And with hundreds still unaccounted for, officials are urging survivors to provide DNA samples to help identify the dead. Overnight, a vigil was held for Joe Schilling. His family says he died a hero, trying to help his elderly neighbors escape the flames. These photos, the last they received from him, showing homes going up in flames.
Always, there isn't anybody in the family or who knew Joe that would be surprised that he would put himself at risk to help somebody else.
Denny Eukert survived, but as he was stuck in traffic with the smoke and flames bearing down on him, he didn't know if he would make it out alive.
You could feel the heat off the traffic.
Denny recording a message to his family, fearing the worst.
My dad, my mom, my son David, I love you all.
Firefighter Ina Kohler was on the scene as the flames took over Lahaina.
Were there moments when you feared for your life?
yeah, a few.
She and her colleagues desperately working to save homes, even as their own burned to the ground. Ina says she and her husband are among the 17 of 18 firefighters who lived in Lahaina and lost their homes. And now residents in Lahaina and Kula have been advised not to drink or even boil water because of what could be in it. But around the island, scenes of hope. At least six donation centers have sprung up organically. Local community members coming together to help those who have lost everything.
We have delivered over 1 million pounds of food, water, and supplies to the Lahaina community.
Morgan Norwood, ABC News, New York.
It was the movie that won Sandra Bullock her first Oscar, telling the story of how Michael Orr overcame poverty to play in the NFL with the help of his adoptive parents. But this morning, Orr is telling a very different story. Here's ABC's Lionel Moyes.
Tony here's your quarterback, all right? You protect his blind side. When you look at him, you think of me.
This morning, a bombshell allegation from the man who was the center of the 2009 film The Blind Side.
It's your decision, Michael. It's your life.
Michael Orr, the real-life inspiration behind that film, says he was blindsided by a family who calls him their son. The Oscar-winning film tells the story of a homeless black teen taken in by a well-off white family in the South, defying the odds to become a first-round NFL draft pick.
I would like to become a legal guardian.
Lord, help that child.
The family telling Good Morning America in 2010, they viewed Michael as a miracle in their home.
Michael's life necessarily wouldn't have been changed if we just wrote a check. He needed our time and our attention.
But in a new petition filed in Shelby County, Tennessee, Orr says Sean and Leanne Tui tricked him into signing what he thought were adoption papers. He says those documents were really for a conservatorship, which he claims the couple used to get rich at his expense. Writing, they only saw him as a gullible young man whose athletic talent could be exploited for their own benefit. Orr also claims the Tuis negotiated for themselves and their two birth children to get a lump sum of more than $200,000 each, plus royalties based on the movie's success. The Tui family has not responded to ABC News' request for comment, but Sean Tui told the Daily Memphian newspaper, "We're devastated," saying the conservatorship was done to avoid any NCAA conflicts with Orr attending Old Miss since Tui is a booster at the school, adding, "It's upsetting that people would think I would want to make money off any of my children, but we're going to love Michael at 37 just like we loved him at 16. Sean Tui says the family, including Orr, got an equal share, about $14,000 each. The attorney for the Tui family tells ESPN the family will file a legal response to the allegations in the coming weeks. Lionel Moyes, ABC News, New York.
All right. Well, coming up on the second half of our newscast, a captain in Southwest Harbor recently caught a rare blue lobster.
We'll check out that and more, along with your full weather forecast as Good Morning Maine continues.
Here we are at Rennie's and Wells on Route 1. Let's go see some people. Come on.
I'm wearing a top and bottom from Rennie's.
Ah, we love that.
Best place to buy candy and other things too, of course, clothing and everything.
You got nice and unique things, and I love the cane shoes you have. I bought cane shoes here.
It's affordable, I should say. Yes.
That's good.
Awesome.
Yes, wonderful.
So I go to almost every one of your Rennie stores.
Rennie's, a Maine adventure.
If you or a loved one has been diagnosed with mesothelioma or asbestos-related lung cancer, contact the law offices of Joe Bornstein to learn about your legal rights. Maine has the highest rate of mesothelioma fatalities in the U.S. You may be eligible to receive compensation if you were exposed to asbestos products while working in a shipyard, mill, factory, or construction site. For a free case evaluation, dial 207-CALL-JOE or online at joebornstein.com.
At Living Innovations, we build community. You can be a part of it. We put supporting people first, and that builds a caring community within our workforce and for the people we serve. Living Innovations supports people with disabilities and has flexible work opportunities available. You could become a shared living provider and work from home, or help support people to be active in the community. To learn more, visit livinginnovations.com and check out our employment and home provider opportunities. Become a part of Living Innovations and be part of a community with a purpose.
It's Great Buy Time at Bob's Small Engine Sales and Service in Bucksport. Now through this August 31st, you can get rebates of up to $1,000 on 2022 CF Moto C-Force Off-Road ATVs, U-Force Utility Side-by-Sides, and Z-Force Side-by-Side Trail and HO Sport models. These inflation-busting rebates of up to $1,000 are only good through this August 31st. Don't wait. See these great buys now at Bob's Small Engine Sales and Service, Route 15, 474 River Road in Bucksport.
You're watching ABC 7 Bangor.
Welcome back, everyone, to Good Morning Maine. Today is Tuesday, August 15th, 2023. Today is also National Back to School Prep Day.
As most of us know, the beginning of the school year is just a week or two away, depending on what school district you're in. And it's time for parents, students, and teachers to start planning for the school year ahead. Do you have all the supplies you need? Do you need some help obtaining those supplies? Is your at-home workstation set up? Now's the time to start thinking about these things.
Pretty timely indeed. In fact, during the next hour, we'll have a special guest here talking about how she's been helping kids get ready to go back to school. A 12-year-old girl who has gathered more than 300 backpacks.
She's gathered a lot.
All on her own. Yeah. So we'll look forward to seeing her during the next
hour. And a diverse collection of backpacks too. Yeah. They're all cute.
Yeah, pretty neat. If everybody did a little something like that, maybe not to that extent.
Yeah, maybe one person brings one. Yeah. If you have one that you're not using even at home, just donate it. I know Pinkwas is probably still accepting
them.
They
still are. Yep. So they're doing their back to school drive right now. So
So if you need one, get start looking for them now because people have them to give away.
Yep. All right. On this day in history, the Mayflower ship set sail from Southampton, England with 102 pilgrims on board. And 15 years later, in 1635, the first ever recorded North American hurricane hit the Plymouth colony. And in 1858, regular U.S. mail to the Pacific coast was able to be sent there.
And in 1911, Procter & Gamble unveiled its Crisco shortening as a product up for sale. I think a lot of recipes were never the same after that.
I grew up, but there was always Crisco in the kitchen. Mom was making pies or whatever with it.
It really levels up your baking.
Yeah.
In 1914, after 10 years of work, the Panama Canal opened up to ships. And in 1979, after a troubled production, Francis Ford Coppola's Apocalypse Now was released in theaters. It had become a film classic, noted for performances by Marlon Brando and Robert Duvall, whose character famously says that he loves the smell of napalm in the morning.
Yeah, can't forget Martin Sheen either. He was fantastic in that movie.
Right.
So for birthdays today, we have actor, writer, and director Ben Affleck, who is 51 years old today. Actress Jennifer Lawrence is 33. And American rapper Chief Keef is 28 years old today. Chief Keef, huh?
Yeah.
I don't know.
I'd sing a Chief Keef song for you right now, but the profanity would get me fired.
The FCC would probably not like the lyrics.
We'd have lawsuits. Yes.
Well, we wish Chief Keef a very happy birthday as well.
Yes, and Jennifer Lawrence and
Ben
Affleck.
She's awesome.
I love all of
them. Yeah.
I love them all.
Yeah.
Yeah. Especially Ben Affleck.
Yeah.
Okay.
He's so hunky.
Yeah, I wouldn't use that word.
He's Batman.
Right.
Did you know that?
Yeah, one of them.
He's pretty cool.
Not the latest Batman, though. Robert Pattinson was the latest Batman.
Yeah, that's right.
And that was a great Batman.
Who's your favorite Batman?
Robert Pattinson.
Really?
Even though I love Ben Affleck.
He was from, like, Harry Potter, so is that why?
Twilight. And he was in one Harry Potter.
Yeah, right.
He died
in
that
one. The goblet fire
thing,
or whatever
Pattinson.
It was.
I love Robert Pattinson. I was a Twilight girl. Yeah. And vampires.
Yeah.
We're really sending this off the rails, though.
All right. Well, let's talk about the weather.
Yeah, it's a good day for a movie.
A little bit of rain today. Yeah. Maybe you can go watch What's his name? Patterson?
Pattinson.
Pattinson.
Yeah. Yeah. Also a Patterson novel day.
I like a good Patterson novel.
We're just riffing on it, grasping for straws.
Here's Devin with your weather forecast.
All righty, thank you very much. Happy Tuesday. Your first weather forecast brought to you by Marilyn Monroe Spas. Sign up for your VIP spa membership today and access exclusive members-only services and benefits. It's the perfect gift for the summer. All right, let's get things rolling after this morning. Some areas of dense fog developing out there. We're noticing a little bit of that in your parts of Caribou this morning. And parts of Washington County seeing some of that as well. Not seeing too much else across the viewing area, at least at this point. We'll be watching for maybe some fog again throughout the morning period today. But for now that we're watching some clouds that are developing out there, we'll be watching for maybe a few showers throughout the afternoon period as well before the sunshine comes out for a little bit. And then later on tonight, areas of dense fog will be developing again. So here's that chance of rain right here, tracking from the southwest to the north and east. So by about late morning to early afternoon, we'll be watching for the rain to move in. Then by about mid to late afternoon, we'll watch for the clouds to break up to reveal some sunshine before it sets later on this evening. Futurecast showing that nicely as we start to see a little bit of sunshine during the afternoon period. And then areas of dense fog and clouds start to move in overnight tonight. So otherwise, the wind's not a huge deal. They will remain rather calm today, mainly at around 5 miles per hour or less. So we're looking pretty good today and also in the parts of tomorrow. So for today, though, upper 70s, scattered showers and becoming partly cloudy with the wind overall looking nice and calm. Later on tonight, upper 50s, mostly cloudy areas of dense fog out there with the wind overall looking nice and calm. Hourly forecast for the rest of the morning and afternoon period, a cloudy sky, chances for showers, temperatures in the 70s. Your full 5 day forecast is coming up.
All right, thank you, Devin. Well, not many lobstermen ever find a blue lobster, but that's exactly what Captain David Layton found in one of his traps yesterday. The blue lobster is incredibly rare. There's approximately a 1 in 2 million chance of finding one. According to the Lobster Institute at the University of Maine, the blue hue comes from a genetic defect that causes the lobster to make excessive amounts of a protein that creates that blue color. Layton took the one that he caught to Beale's Lobster Pier in Southwest Harbor, where they took pictures of the lobster before they set it free back into the ocean. So maybe somebody else will find it eventually.
If I didn't hear the story myself, I'd think it was photoshopped.
Yeah, it's kind of neat. I was actually on a boat one time when they pulled one up, a buddy of mine. He had been fishing all his life and finally got one, and you would have thought that he won the lottery. It was pretty exciting.
But that's cool.
It's very neat.
Yeah, a good omen, I'd say.
Yeah.
All right, still to come here on the morning show, Tyler Cruz will have the latest with sports.
Don't go away.
Wow, with fuel prices quickly rising and no end in sight, isn't it time to give Black's Heat Pumps a call? Did you know heat pumps could save you up to 50% on your heating bill? Our experts can handle all your commercial and residential work and provide you with quality installation, repair, and maintenance. Give us a call today for a free estimate. Our number one priority is to save you money and keep you comfortable all year long. Get the service you deserve. Find us at blacksheatpumps.com and on Facebook.
The Farmer's Table in Corinna brings you outstanding breakfasts, lunches, and dinners made from farm-grown fresh ingredients. Dinner specials are available every day. Enjoy our homemade desserts, and above all, bring your appetite to the Farmer's Table in Corinna. Harris Lumber is locally owned and has been serving the Penquis region for more than 50 years. See them for all your projects, big or small. Customer service is their number one priority. And with a full line of lumber and hardware items, they can also deliver to your job site. Harris Lumber, Milo. If I don't hear from you tonight,
Dot, dot, dot. Am I supposed to read the dot, dot, dot? More than that. You know there's not nothing. Feels for you. Feelings for you. Hey. I'm catching feels for you. You feel like something. Good morning, America.
Welcome back in, everyone. Thank you for staying with us. Let's start with some baseball here. Down in Williamsport, Pennsylvania, the Gray New Gloucester Raymond Little League All-Star team is gearing up for Game 1 of the World Series. They take on the Northwest Champs from Seattle on Thursday. Earlier on Monday, the Little League Series officially kicking off with the teams taking part in the Little League World Series Parade. An estimated 30,000 to 40,000 fans were on hand to welcome teams from all over the world. The Gray, New Gloucester, and Raymond folks are the first team to represent Maine in the World Series in almost 20 years. And earlier, the team reacting to the thrill of playing at the classic Llama Day Stadium.
We're just getting ready. We're taking it day by day, trying to stay healthy. Just the mental, you know, we're all ready to play and have fun. They've got, you know, indoor climate-controlled batting cages for these boys. There's multiple practice fields that are nicer than anything we've ever played on. And then, of course, what you see behind me here, Lomity Field, where all of the United States games are played. Just below that's Volunteer Field, where all the international games are played. It's just breathtaking.
All right, certainly a once-in-a-lifetime experience for those kids. Let's move on now. Happy Fall Sports Day to all who celebrate. As of Monday, the 2023-24 high school sports season is officially underway. Let's check out some dates to mark on those calendars for the fall season ahead of us. As I just said, August 14th, Monday, marks the first official practice for all fall sports teams in our area. On the 25th, golf teams can get out for their first countable match, and then less than a week after, all other sports begin play as well. Golf states are October 6th and 7th this fall, with cross-country states later in the month on the 28th. On November 4th, field hockey and soccer will play their state championships. Some games may be played on the 3rd, and on the 11th, we'll have the 8-man football finals, and then that following Saturday will be the football state championships for classes A through D on the 18th, wrapping up the fall season. And then on the 20th, winter sports starts. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. This fall at Brewer boys and girls soccer, as well as their field hockey program, will all be enjoying their last seasons on historic Doyle Field before a new present is unwrapped before the end of the year.
I'm so excited. I can't wait.
By next spring, basically all outdoor sports at Brewer High School will have a new home. A brand new artificial turf covered complex right in the shadow of Coffin Field.
It's gonna be awesome. I mean, I've been playing on turf facilities all summer, so it's a great experience, and it's gonna be fun being at home, like in Brewer.
So it's really gonna be a huge thing. I also play field hockey, and being down here, watching them redo the turf and stuff for us, it's gonna be crazy.
I'm really excited. I'm definitely the person who likes playing on turf more than grass.
We've been waiting for this a couple of years, so I mean, it feels honestly great to get some new turf and feel like even more at home playing here.
Just under the lights, like it's what every little kid hopes for when they like get to high school. They want to be that varsity kid in the environment, and I think that turf field's going to bring that for us.
Starting with baseball, Hederick Field will be redone into an all-turf facility for their upcoming season, bringing back the classic Fill the Hill nights.
Fill the Hill is when we both play at the same time, and we try and get as many students and staff here that we can, and just fans and supporters, and watch us play.
It was a great experience. It was really fun, and I enjoyed it, and I look forward to it.
And that way we're able to have baseball going on one side, softball the other. Everyone's loud. It's a great night.
Behind Hederick, new tennis courts, as well as a field for soccer, field hockey, and lacrosse, something that's going to be huge for the whole Brewer athletics community.
Also, fans migrating around, they could be watching a softball game or they could go down to the lacrosse games. I think it's just going to be a different atmosphere, and I'm really excited for it.
Kids coming up, it's going to be fun just to kind of go and hang out there.
It's just going to be a bigger atmosphere, and it's going to feel great.
Athletic Director Dave Utterback says they expect the project to be complete before winter. And for the athletes, they're all extremely grateful for the investment.
It's very humbling, just that like Utterback trusts us with that. He's putting so much money in our school, is putting so much money in us and our sports, and I think it's like very humbling and very, like, we're very grateful for it.
Looking forward to see how that turns out. Let's move on to some football now. Patriots preparing to take on the Packers on Friday, but some roster moves coming on Monday. New England is bringing in a running back, former Dallas Cowboys and first-round pick. He was actually picked fourth overall. Ezekiel Elliott will be joining the Patriots' backfield. Elliott, a few years ago, was one of the best backs in the league. He's coming to Foxborough on a one-year deal worth up to $6 million. How times have changed. He's a three-time Pro Bowler and twice has led the NFL in rushing. Should be a great addition to Ramondre Stevenson in that Pats running back room. All right, that's all the time we have for sports. Be right back after the break.
this looks like a summer blockbuster, but this is a Nissan sales event ahead.
Now get a low $299 per month lease on Rogue.
Better hurry. These offers won't get a sequel.
This fall, you'll vote on a costly electric scheme. It's called Pine Tree Power. And here are the facts. It will cost Mainers $13.5 billion. An independent study says it will increase electric bills. And this scheme is so poorly written, Pine Tree Power isn't required to have an operations plan when it takes over. No plan to keep the lights on. That's a bad idea. Vote no on question 3.
Acadia Gem EV Rentals, the clean, all-electric, and fun way to see Bar Harbor and Acadia National Park. Gem vehicles are 100% electric, low-speed vehicles that are street legal on any paved road with a posted speed limit of 35 miles an hour or less. You will enjoy all the beauty of the island without leaving a carbon footprint. Gem rentals are available in 2, 4, and 6-passenger vehicles. Visit acadiagem.com or call 207-288-8983.
I know this looks like a summer blockbuster, but this is a Nissan sales event ahead.
Now get a low $299 per month lease on Rogue.
Better hurry. These offers won't get a sequel.
Retirees could be seeing a cut to their Social Security checks in the future. The nonprofit Committee for a Responsible Federal Budget reports a major reduction of benefits could occur in 2033, which is when trust fund reserves are expected to run out. The report says newly retired dual-income couples could have their checks cut by more than $17,000 a year. To avoid reduced checks, policy experts say Congress needs to act. Some Democratic lawmakers suggest removing the cap that allows higher income earners to be exempt from the Social Security payroll tax, while some Republican lawmakers say raising the retirement age to 70 is a better solution.
Colleges are looking for new ways to chat GPT-proof assignments and catch cheating. Some students are now turning to ChatGPT. Never heard of it before. Is that a thing, Emma?
That's like the AI writer.
Oh, okay.
That's something that you plug in a few words or a sentence.
And then the artificial intelligence will do it for you.
Yes, this is what people are talking about when they're talking about AI.
All right. Well, they're now turning to that to get help with assignments. The artificial intelligence bot uses unique words when generating text, making it difficult for professors to find out whether students are using the tool. In order to prevent cheating, some educators are now going back to paper exams and doing away with digital ones. Some professors are also requiring students to provide their editing history and drafts as well.
It makes sense, I get it. Yeah. I mean, it's so easy to have that write a whole essay for you, and it's very realistic. All right, well, in other news now, pollution could be raising dementia risks, according to a new study. New research published in the medical journal JAMA Network finds those who live in areas with high levels of air pollution are more likely to develop dementia than those who don't live in air-polluted areas. Researchers looked at more than 27,000 people from 1998 to 2016. Researchers found that areas with pollution from wildfires and agriculture specifically have a greater link to dementia compared to other types of pollution such as sources from cars or construction sites. There's all sorts of ways to inhale or have pollution kind of come in contact with your body, and I think it's different for different areas of our state even.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're lucky we live in one of the cleaner ones, actually.
Right. For the state as a whole, it's better. Yeah. Yep.
Well, we'll get a little rain today that will help clear the air. How do you like that?
Good point.
Yeah.
Yeah. Here's Devin Banks with our full forecast.
All righty, happy Tuesday. Your full weather forecast brought to you by Marilyn Monroe Spas. Sign up for your VIP spa membership today and access exclusive members-only services and benefits. It's a perfect gift for the summer. Already, some areas have been fog developing out this morning, mainly near across parts of the Caribou area, near parts of Washington County as well. Everyone else looking okay for the time being. Maybe some patchy fog possible in a few spots this morning. For now, we're just watching clouds that are developing out there, tracking from the west, going toward the east. We're watching more rain as solid for the west as well. This will be heading in our direction throughout the late morning into the early afternoon period as well. Then by around mid to late afternoon, we'll be watching for the clouds to break up just a bit to reveal some sunshine, courtesy of this area low pressure right about here. High pressure to the north will also be our friend as it will help to push some of the clouds away later on. But for now, though, futurecast moving forward showing clouds today with a few showers possible during the late morning to early afternoon. Then by around mid to late afternoon in the parts of the evening, the clouds break up. But notice what happens. The clouds move back in. Areas of dense fog also possible, and some that could linger in the parts of Wednesday morning as well. We'll hold on to the clouds for your Wednesday. Slight chance for a shower or so. Then by around late in the day on Wednesday, the clouds will break up to reveal some sunshine before it begins to set. And then Wednesday night, more areas of dense fog will look to develop. So moving forward, though, today and tomorrow, nothing meaningful in the form of rain. Maybe a tenth of an inch or less between now and early Thursday morning before we're all finished up. Later into the week, though, as we head towards Friday or so, we're going to be watching for more rain. It will be on the way. Maybe some locally higher amounts in your parts of Washington County. It will be very scattered in nature. So by around Friday or so, more rain will be on the way. Our average high temperature is 80 degrees. Upper 70s is what we'll do for us today. Middle 70s Wednesday. Back in the upper 70s for your Thursday. Middle 70s Friday into Saturday. Upper 70s again for your Sunday. And upper 70s again as we head towards your Monday. So as we talk about the dew points, so they will remain in the 60s over the next few days between today and also the parts of Thursday. By Friday, though, here we go. Middle 60s on the way before we catch a little bit of a break. So for today, though, scattered showers, temperatures in the upper 70s and becoming partly cloudy with the wind overall looking nice and calm. Upper 50s for tonight, mostly cloudy areas of dense fog on the way with the wind overall looking nice and calm. And for tomorrow, middle 70s on the way, mostly cloudy with a slight chance for a shower. Southeast wind at about 5 miles per hour. Marilyn Monroe Spa's extended forecast for mostly cloudy for your Thursday, highs in the upper 70s, middle 70s Friday with a chance for storms, and we're dry on Saturday, partly cloudy, highs in the mid 70s.
Well, that will about do it for us for this hour anyway.
If you missed anything, head to foxbangor.com.
Have a great day.